Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at creating an SSH tunnel with PuTTY on Windows. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at The Urban Penguin, and on Facebook, you'll be able to like my page as The Urban Penguin. So an SSH tunnel is an encrypted tunnel between usually your local host and the service that you want to connect to. So we can run this with the free download PuTTY, and you can see I'm on my Windows device here at the moment. And we can then create a saved session. For want of a better name, I'm just going to use forward here. And then I can connect as a user to my remote Linux host. My remote Linux host is running VNC, and I want an encrypted connection for VNC. So we can use then the SSH tunnel for this. The VNC service is running then on the 192.168.0.60 machine. At the moment, I'm just going to save my settings, but we don't connect at the moment. We move through connect to connections, and then SSH and tunnels. We can leave the settings at default, but first we then go into a source port and choose a port that's not currently in use on your local machine. So I'm just using 9090, any high number will be generally good. And we're going to then connect into the VNC service on the 60 machine on port 5902. We go back now to our session and we can save that. What I might do is actually I might just change to the Andrew user, because I think TUP doesn't have a password and I won't be able to log in via SSH with no password. So we save that. It doesn't really matter the user account you use to log on to SSH with. So you can see I'm making my connection now. So of course I'm going to need to put in Andrew's password. And you can say, well, this is just a command line connection. Yeah, but that's okay. Let's go through and look in the event log and just check that everything worked. Now, when we go through, we're looking for the fact that we're listening on port 9090 and forwarding through this tunnel to the 60 machine and port 5902. So now I start up my VNC viewer. I point it to the local host and port 9090. So you can see even in the dialog box here, I'm connecting to the local host and we're redirecting through to the server and now connecting via SSH over the network. And only when we get to the server are we then using the VNC port. So this way we've got a secure connection from my client through to the VNC server. So this is what SSH tunneling is all about, and I hope you found it useful. And I'll see you again on theurbanpenguin.com soon.